Good job, Papi. Game four. That's it.
We gotta go. We gotta go back to LA.
I know. Now you have to go back to LA. Hey, careful with the grass. Grounds crew.
Let's get my shoes dirty, though.
Grounds crew. They got careful with the grass. They don't like it.
Chaldei, tú lo tienes que enviar esto a los celulares porque
esto obligado.
Eso es obligado, que no aquí pelea.
I'm mesmerized. It's absolutely gorgeous inside. I can't even explain it because we weren't supposed to take video in there, but I snuck some on the GoPro, so we'll see what that looks like when I go and edit inside.
So, as I just mentioned before, we're currently at a mandir, which is basically a place of worship for those who practice Hinduism. Now, you're probably wondering, why would I come all the way to Houston to visit a Hindu church? But look at this place. It is absolutely beautiful. And one thing I always try and do when I travel is to get out of the mainstream tourism things and just find unique things to each and every city or place that I visit. And this, to me, was a must-see. It is absolutely beautiful. Built in 2004 out in the suburb in Houston, it was only took about 28 months to build, which is incredible because it consists of 33,000 pieces of hand-carved Italian marble and Turkish limestone, all shipped over to Texas and then built piece by piece, totally by volunteers. Now, luckily, the people at this church or at this cultural center allow visitors to come and learn about Hinduism. And so I took the opportunity to go inside, but warning, you're not allowed to wear your shoes and you're not allowed to take cameras inside. We kind of failed at both. The security guard stopped us when we were walking up the steps, so we did remove our shoes. However, I was able to, well, let's just say my GoPro accidentally stayed on in my back pocket as I was touring this place. If you're visiting Houston and just looking for something different and unique to do, I definitely recommend going to visit the Mandir. They're open daily to visitors and it's free of charge. It's like a little piece of Asia right in the middle of the city of Houston, Texas, which is so bizarre. So I like that contrast. I thought it was very interesting. So I definitely went and I'm so happy that I did. And then also I should mention, as beautiful as it is during the day, I didn't go at night because we had obviously the game that we were there for, the World Series game, but they light it up in these beautiful colors. And I hear, right, from views of the pictures I've seen on their website, it is stunning.
But if you ever come to Houston, you definitely have to visit this place. This is my, one of my best days at home. So, anyways, I think that's it for this. We'll catch you in a little bit.
The next morning.
Good morning, world. Back. What? Last day here in Houston. And we have incredible weather today. I'd say it was probably in the 60s, which is chilly, I suppose. We're getting into fall, but the sun is out. At least there's no wind blowing to chill us. So today we're going to... What are we doing today?
Brunch.
Right now we're going to go meet up with the rest of the family. And we're gonna go to this restaurant called Papa Do's, which is a New Orleans style restaurant, and it's delicious to go eat. And then from there, we're gonna venture downtown, maybe check out the museum if there's time, and the Bayou Park down in central Houston. So yeah, we're just trying to get some last minute things in before we fly out early tomorrow. All right, catch y'all later.
Check. been a minute since I've been with some women. Not because they've been lacking, just I've been lacking the feeling. I've been...
All right, traveler. So at this point, you're probably wondering, where in the hell did I just take you guys? This is a cistern at Buffalo Bayou Park. It was a former drinking water reservoir built in 1926 for the city of Houston. As one of the city's earliest underground reservoirs, it supported municipal water system goals for fire suppression and for drinking water storage. The cistern holds about 15 million gallons of water when functioning at capacity. And after operating for decades, unfortunately, a leak was discovered that couldn't be repaired, so they ended up decommissioning the reservoir back in 2007. At this point, the city was then sourcing vendors to demolish the cistern. Simultaneously, Buffalo Bayou Partnership was developing a park project just above the cistern, which was going to cost them about $58 million to redo. And after many years of being decommissioned, they rediscovered this beautiful and unusual place hidden underground. Recognizing the historical and architectural significance of this underground reservoir, the BBP, working with the City of Houston, restored and repurposed the cistern into a magnificent public space to house an ambitious program of changing the way people do art installations. Okay, so I know it's incredibly difficult to see because the lights are dim, but this place is massive. It measures at about 87,500 square feet, or 1.5 football fields to be exact. As your eyes span the room, you'll notice there are hundreds of slender concrete columns spanning throughout the space, 221 to be exact, each of them 25 feet tall. If you come visit Houston, I 100% recommend coming to the Buffalo Bayou Park Cistern. Every city that I try and visit, I always look for the unique, non-touristy, but I guess this is kind of touristy, but different things about the city that one wouldn't ordinarily find when visiting a new city. Yes, this is about the history of Houston's water system. Doesn't sound very exciting, but look at this space. I mean, it is incredible, and I'm so happy that I was able to at least learn a little about the water system in Houston, I guess, but also to reflect on just how incredible our engineering was decades ago and what a transformation that this place is going to be now being used as an art space where there will project footage on the walls and use the sound and the acoustics in this space to create this magnificent show. I know they have some videos on their website about this kind of stuff where you can get more information. I will link it down below. Go check it out. It's only $5, a 30-minute tour, and it's so beautiful. Seriously, your mind is going to be mind blown.
Moments later.
What's up, everybody? First time in Houston, and actually I didn't have any expectations. I wasn't sure if this would be an interesting city or what to expect, actually, but I am pleasantly surprised. Houston has been incredible. The excitement for the Astros in the World Series has been paramount to how much fun we've been having. You can just feel the city alive, which is something great, because after Hurricane Harvey and all the destruction and damage that it caused, I think this city needed something to uplift it. And what better than, you know, a championship, potential championship team, or a World Series championship team. So later on, we're going to go to the World Series game. That was the whole purpose of this trip. But right now, we're just going to enjoy the remainder of our last evening in Houston. Excuse me, I'm getting sick. And just, enjoy this moment.
3:28 a.m.
Legit.
Look, it's me. It's the guy from nowhere.
One of the most... Get out of here. One of the most incredible games ever. It's currently 1:30. Tired. My flight's at 6.
How hard can it be?
Uncle George.
To block somebody? How hard can it be, right?
Hey, look at that. Look at that.
Are you pissed? Are you pissed?
You know what? We lost two. We lost a great game. I'm not pissed.
We can come back. No, it was a great game.
It was a great game.
We can come back.